Yes, very good morning to all of you. So we were revising polynomials. First concept of the chapter, that is some questions based on the definitions that we have discussed yesterday. Today we'll start with the next concept of the chapter, that is zero of the polynomial. Very important concept of the chapter, that is zero of the polynomial. So you should know the meaning, and then we will start with the application of that meaning and the question based on this meaning. What is the zero of the polynomial? Prabhjot Singh, would you please switch on your video only, then I will answer your query. Prabhjot Singh. Yes, Prabhjot. Hanji, boliye.
Ma'am, is baar polynomials pure aayenge ki jitne pichle term mein aaye the utna hi?
Nahi, nahi, bachche, the whole chapter. Today I will put the syllabus in the group.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
So today is the turn of 31 to 40 roll number to send their notebooks. Otherwise 1 to 30, if someone is defaulter, they can send it today. Don't insist me that I should call your parents and complain against you. Better to be the talk between me and you only and send your work timely. Zero of the polynomial. So if we are talking about polynomial, if we are talking about zero of polynomial, first of all, we should have a polynomial. So let me take Px as a polynomial. If there is a polynomial Px and now zero, let us take a number to be zero, A. Px is a polynomial, A is a number, A will be the zero of the polynomial. If it will make the polynomial to be zero, khud to zero hai hi, khud ka naam zero hai, iska name zero hai, iski value zero nahi hai. There is difference between these two things. Please keep in mind. This is, its name is zero. Its value is not zero always. Ho sakti hai, but not always. Right? So this A, its name is zero. It will become the zero of the polynomial if it, you can say, justify its name. Justify its name is when it will be put in the polynomial, the answer should be equal to zero. So number A, it is said to be zero of the polynomial Px. If we replace the variable by this number and the answer comes out to be zero. When we say a number A is zero of the polynomial Px, if by replacing A in that polynomial, that is in place of variable, when we are replacing A, if the answer comes out to be zero, then we say that this number A, it is a zero of the given polynomial. So, ye aapka meaning hai zero ka. Questions जो हैं हमारे वो इस पे बेस्ड होंगे, that will be on the definition of zero. So जो first definition है कि zero कब बनती है किसी polynomial की, जब उसको put करो और answer zero आ जाए. For example, if I'm taking one question based on this definition, इस definition पे based अगर हम एक question लें, और you can say कि देखें कि zero पे based कैसे कैसे conceptual questions हमें आ सकते हैं, तो देखें जरा. So suppose I am having a polynomial y square plus 2y plus 9. And he says, check whether y is equal to 3 is zero of polynomial or not. Check whether y is equal to 3 is zero of the polynomial or not. First of all, we have to name this polynomial, that I am naming it as py. That is y square plus 2y plus 9. Now, according to definition, this number, it will be zero of this polynomial if by replacing this number, the answer comes out to be the zero. So I'm replacing y by 3. So this will be 3 square plus 2 into 3 plus 9. That is 9 plus 6 plus 9. That is equal to 24. So when I'm replacing this polynomial y by 3, I'm getting the answer to be 24, which is not equal to 0, which contradicts the definition of the 0 of the polynomial, that the answer should be 0, only then the number will be the 0, number will become the 0. Therefore, due to definition, we'll say that this number 3 is not going to be the 0 of the given polynomial. So this is the first type of the question, which is based on the concept of the zero of the polynomial. And this is your second concept of the chapter. First was on the basis of डेफिनेशन कि जीरो को हम चेक कैसे करते हैं, किसी पॉलिनोमियल का कोई नंबर जीरो है या नहीं, हाउ वी डिटेक्ट इट। एंड बिफोर दैट यू नो आई एम फाइंडिंग हियर पी ऑफ थ्री, so you should know how to what is the meaning of p of 3 means in the polynomial wherever y is present we have to replace that y by 3. Sometimes the question can be like this also, that you are given a polynomial qx, you are given a polynomial qx like this, x cube plus 3x square plus 3x plus 1, and you need to find q of minus 2, q of minus 3 plus q of 1 by 2. This kind of question, it was there in the exam also previously. So this is, you should know how to find this. Zero of the polynomial mein humne isko use kiya rather, to ye pehle concept consider karna chahiye tha. Anyhow, so this question is actually consisting of the three questions. That means you need to find q of minus 2, you need to find q of minus 3, you need to find q of 1 by 2, and after that, whatever values you are getting of q of minus 2, q of minus 3, and q of 1 by 2, these values, they are to be added, and accordingly, you will get the answer, right? So first of all, I'm finding q of minus 2, very easy, wherever x is there, replace it by minus 2. Wherever you are getting x, you have to replace that x by minus 2. This is minus 8, 12 minus 6 plus 1, 4 minus 6 plus 1, minus 2 plus 1, answer is minus 1. Q of minus 10, 2 you are getting, this is minus 2. Let us find Q of minus 3. Q of minus 3, that means in place of x, you have to put 3. In place of x, you have to put 3, minus 3, sorry, plus 1, right? Wherever x is there, you have to replace it by minus 3. So this is this get cancelled, minus 8. So q of minus 3, you are getting it to be minus 8. Now we are finding q of 1 by 2. That is equal to 1 by 2 cube. 3 into 1 by 2 square, 3 into 1 by 2 plus 1, right? So this is equal to 1 by 8 plus 3 by 4 plus 3 by 2 plus 1. 8 will be the LCM. This is 27 upon 8. So all the values you have detected separately, q of minus 2 you find out, it comes out to be minus 1. You find out q of minus 3 comes out to be minus 8, and q of 1 of 2 come out to be 27 by 8. Place the value in the required expression, which is to be find out. This is minus 1 plus minus 8 plus 27 upon 8. So you can take 8 as LCM. This is minus 8, minus 64, plus 24, minus 72, plus 24 upon 8, minus 48 upon 8. So this is minus 6. So the answer comes out to be minus 6. Such kind of question in which you have to find the value of certain expression by replacing the value in the given polynomial. Given polynomial mein value put karke, jab aapne expression ki value find karni hai, aise questions, these type of questions are also there. Chaliye. So we were doing concept of zero, and we learned that how to verify, how to check whether the given number is zero of the polynomial or not. The given number jo hai, वो पॉलिनोमियल का जीरो है या नहीं, ये फाइंड करना। तो पहला क्वेश्चन हमने सेकंड कॉन्सेप्ट जीरो वाले पे बेस पे ये किया दैट हाउ टू चेक वेदर द गिवन नंबर इज जीरो ऑफ द पॉलीनोमियल और नॉट. सेकंड हाउ टू फाइंड द जीरोस. How to find the zeros of a polynomial? Zeros find कैसे करते हैं? Polynomials तो बहुत तरह की हैं. Linear है, quadratic है, cubic है. किस किस केस में हम zeros को find करेंगे? Cubic and quadratic. Sorry, linear and quadratic. Cubic is not in your syllabus. आप सिर्फ quadratic और linear के केस में जो zeros हैं उनको find करना सीखोगे. तो अगर मैं लीनियर पॉलिनोमियल कोई बात करूं, सपोज द पॉलिनोमियल इज 5x plus 4 एंड द क्वेश्चन इज फाइंड इट्स जीरोस. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू नेम इट. px इज इक्वल टू, इफ इट इज इन द वेरिएबल x, इट इज टू बी नेम एज px. सो फॉर जीरोस वी राइट फोर जीरोस. क्या स्टेप होता है जीरोस फाइंड करने का? वट एवर पॉलिनोमियल इज गिवन, इक्वेट इट टू बी जीरो. हम कंडीशन स्टार्टिंग में ही लेके चलते हैं किस पॉलिनोमियल को हमने जीरो के इक्वल पुट कर दिया. You know that whenever we have to find some variable, we need equation. Equation कैसे बनी? इसको zero के equal equate करके. So whenever the zeros are to be find out, the given polynomial is to be equated to zero. So this is 5x plus 4 equal to zero. So 5x is equal to minus 4. So x is equal to minus 4 upon 5. This is the answer for the zero of the polynomial. The way you will find the zero of the polynomial is just putting the polynomial to be equal to zero, right? And ek hum quadratic ka bhi karte hain. Quadratic polynomial koi consider karte hain, uski zeros find karte hain. Jaise ki hamare paas polynomial hai 2y square plus 6y plus 5y minus 3, iski zeros find karo. This is a quadratic polynomial. First of all, we name it as py because it is a polynomial in y, variable y, right? So we write four zeros, this polynomial is to be equated to zero. That is 2y square plus 5y minus 3 equal to zero. So you know, this is a quadratic polynomial. We need to find the value of pi. 9 and 16, 9c, ये कौन है भी? धैर्य का नाम लिखा हुआ है. रोल नंबर 9 एंड 16. शुड आई रिमूव और स्विच ऑन योर वीडियो? हु इज दिस 9 एंड 16? मेरी क्लास में 9 रोल नंबर अलग है, 16 रोल नंबर अलग है. देर इज नो स्टूडेंट हु इज हैविंग बोथ दिस, हु इज ओइंग बोथ ऑफ दिस रोल नंबर. नो, यूर रेजिंग हैंड इज नॉट द इंडिकेशन दैट यू आर माई स्टूडेंट. Switching on your video will prove that you are my student. Otherwise, I'm going to remove you. Hanji, why you are writing 9 and 16? There you are. I'm unmuting you.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, oh, Harshit, ma'am, mere ghar pe aaya hua, to ma'am, katthe laga rahe hain class.
Can I see her? Can I see Harshit? Harshit, where is your notebook? Idhar aayi zara. Come in front of camera. Notebook, test, हॉलीडेज होमवर्क कुछ भी नहीं, मतलब भेजना है ना?
मैं घर जाके भेज दूंगा.
ये भेजा हुआ है कुछ, मुझे लगता है नोटबुक कल आधी बचादी आ गई है मेरे पास, है ना?
यस.
चलो कंप्लीटली अपना वर्क भेजो. ओके, चलिए. सो दिस इज द क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलिनोमियल व्हिच इज टू बी सॉल्व. And in 8th standard, you learned how to solve a quadratic polynomial. We can solve a quadratic polynomial by splitting its middle term. So 5 is to be split in two parts such that their multiplication is 6 and add subtract karke 5. 2 threes are 6. Aap isko 2 and 3 mein break kar sakte ho. So I'm writing, this is 2y, 3y minus 3 equal to 0. एंड यू नो यहाँ पे एक चीज का ध्यान रखना है आपने. 5y इट इज विद प्लस साइन, सो बड़े का जो आंसर का साइन होगा वो बड़े का साइन हो जाता होता है, यू नो. एंड द स्मॉलर साइन विल बी डिसाइडेड बाय दिस. इफ आई पुट माइनस हियर, 3 माइनस 2 इट विल बिकम 1, आई नीड 5. सो प्लस 3 के साथ प्लस 2 विल बी अटैच्ड. Okay, so combine these two, 2y taken as common inside y plus 1 plus 3 as common. अच्छा यहाँ पे माइनस है, यहाँ पे प्लस करो. This is plus 3 as common, y plus 1 equal to 0. So you are having 2y plus 3 into y plus 1 equal to 0. दो ब्रैकेट्स का प्रोडक्ट 0 है, that means either the first is equal to 0 or the second is equal to 0. So equating the first expression to be equal to 0 and the second expression to be equal to 0. So you will be having 2y is equal to minus 3. So y is equal to minus 3 upon 2 and y is equal to minus 1. These two, they are going to be the zeros of the given quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial tak aapne karna hai, cubic ko hum cubic ki zeros find karne ka hum nahi kar rahe abhi. सिलेबस में हमारे नहीं है. तो क्वाड्रेटिक की जीरोस कैसे फाइंड करेंगे? यू विल सॉल्व द क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन बाय स्प्लिटिंग द मिडल टर्म. चलिए नोट डाउन सम क्वेश्चंस. हाँ चलो पहले नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट करते हैं, फिर क्वेश्चंस आपको दूंगी करने के लिए. नेक्स्ट जो हमने जीरो की एप्लीकेशन की थी, दैट इज वी आर गिवन द जीरो विद द हेल्प ऑफ विच वी हैव टू फाइंड द अननोन. फॉर एग्जांपल नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, फाइंड के इफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू 5 इज जीरो ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस 2kx प्लस 9. इफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू 5 इज जीरो ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस 2x प्लस 2kx प्लस 9. तो सबसे पहले इसका नेम रखो, px इज इक्वल टू एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस 2kx प्लस 9. दिस इज द नेम ऑफ द पॉलीनोमियल. व्हाट इज गिवन टू अस? इट इज गिवन दैट 5 इज द जीरो ऑफ दिस पॉलीनोमियल. 5 इस पॉलीनोमियल का जीरो है. इट मींस स्टार्टिंग में ही हमें कंडीशन लेके चलनी पड़ेगी, एज 5 इज जीरो ऑफ दिस पॉलीनोमियल, सो p ऑफ 5 इज इक्वल टू 0. दैट मींस पुटिंग x, रिप्लेसिंग x बाय 5 इन द गिवन पॉलीनोमियल, यू विल गेट दिस. सो दिस इज 25 प्लस nk, 5 टू 10k प्लस 9 इक्वल टू 0. 9 प्लस 24, लाइक टर्म्स आर टू बी एडेड, दिस इज 34 इज इक्वल टू 0. सो फ्रॉम हियर you will detect k like, so 10k is equal to 34, k is equal to 34 upon 10, so k is equal to 17 upon 5. This is answer. This way you will solve it and you will find the value. So three type of questions: to check the zeros, putting the value, getting the answer to be zero. Okay, not otherwise it's not a zero. Second type of question is you have to find the zeros. That means putting the equation to be, putting the polynomial to be equal to zero and finding the zeros accordingly. And third type of question, zero is given with the help of which you have to find the unknown variable, that is k. Lakshya Sharma, take your seat. Don't move here and there in your house. Lakshya Sharma, you can take your seat. Chaliye. Anyhow, so these are the three, four type of questions which you have to see on the basis of the zeros of the polynomial. Chaliye. Now I'm giving you some of the questions that you will do yourself. Check whether x is equal to 5 is 0 of x square plus 9x plus 9 or no. Find zeros of 3y square plus 9y plus 6. If y is equal to 3 is 0 of y square plus 2yp plus 9, find p. These are the question for your practice based on the based on today's lecture. Chaliye, next. Now there are some properties of the zero of the polynomial. जो हमने zero of the polynomial का concept किया, उसकी कुछ properties हैं जिसको हम एक मिनट के लिए देखें जरा क्या क्या. First of all, ये जो number zero है, it can be zero of a polynomial. Zero भी किसी polynomial की zero बन सकती है. Zero can be the zero of a polynomial. जैसे कि मेरे पास एक पॉलिनोमियल है से एक्स क्यूब, इसमें जीरो पुट करोगे आंसर जीरो आएगा. तो जीरो इज द जीरो ऑफ दिस पॉलिनोमियल. जीरो कैन बी द जीरो ऑफ ए पॉलिनोमियल. एवरी लीनियर पॉलिनोमियल हैज ओनली वन जीरो has only one zero. Every linear polynomial has only one zero. Maximum number of zeros that a polynomial can have is the degree of the polynomial, is that of the degree of the polynomial. Let me explain how. Maximum number of zeros that a polynomial can have is the degree of the polynomial. That means if you are having a cubic polynomial and someone is asking you that how many maximum zeros it can have, zyada se zyada cubic polynomial ki kitni zeros ho sakti hain, jitni uski degree hai, cubic polynomial ki degree 3 hai, so maximum zeros bhi cubic polynomial ki 3 hoengi. Similarly, if you are having a polynomial of degree 2 quadratic, uski zeros maximum 2 hi aayengi, 2 se zyada nahi aayengi. If you are having a polynomial of degree 5, then it will be having maximum 5 zeros. If you are having a polynomial of degree 6, it will be having 6 zeros maximum. That means if you are having a polynomial of degree n, then maximum number of zeros that that polynomial can have is equal to n. Jis polynomial ki degree n hai, uski maximum zeros hamare paas n hongi. Maximum number of zeros that a polynomial can have is a degree of the polynomial. Ye polynomial zeros ki kuch zero ki kuch properties that you have to remember. Chaliye. See the next question. If x is equal to 3 and x is equal to 0, x is equal to 3 and x is equal to 0, are the zeros of the polynomial, are the zeros of the polynomial 2x cube minus 8x square plus ax plus b, find a and b. दो जीरोस दी हुई हैं एक इक्वेशन की और उनकी इस चीज की हेल्प, इस गिवन की हेल्प से वी नीड टू फाइंड द वैल्यूज ऑफ ए एंड बी, हमें ए एंड बी की वैल्यू फाइंड करनी है इस गिवन के हेल्प से. You know, when we need to find the two variables, as we can see in this question, we have to find A and B. That means two variables are needed. Then we need two equations. And to detect two equations, we need two conditions. And two conditions are given to us. First condition is x is equal to 3, it's a 0. And the second condition is x is equal to 0, is it's a 0. So I'm, first of all, I'm naming it as 2x cube minus 8x square plus ax plus b. First condition use karo. As x is equal to 3, is it's 0. So p of 3 equal to 0. First condition is x is equal to 3, is it's 0. So accordingly, I'm putting p of 3 equal to 0. I'm taking. So x ki jagah pe aap 3 put karte jao. Replacing x by 3. Replacing x by 3, so you will be having 3a plus b minus 18 equal to 0. That means 3a plus b is equal to 18, equation number 1. So, jo first aapne condition use ki, from that you deduce the first equation, that is 3a plus b is equal to 18. Now, we are also given that x is equal to 0, is it 0. So, using that condition, you will be having p of 0 is equal to 0, putting the value 2 into 0 cube minus 8 into 0 square plus a into 0 plus b, this is equal to 0. 0 into something 0, sara kuch 0 ban jayega, so b ki value aapke paas 0 hai. This is equation number 2. In equation number 2, b comes out to be 0, put in equation number 1 and get a. So hum b ko, b ki value jo aayi hai, usko equation number 1 mein put kare. From 1, using 2, this is 3a plus b is equal to 18. So put b is equal to 0. 3a is equal to 18. So this implies a is equal to 18 upon 3. A comes out to be 6. Okay, so such kind of question. This is the application of the concept of the 0. That with the help of the concept of the 0 of the polynomial, how you can find the unknowns which are involved in the polynomial. These are the two unknowns, A and B. We find it out by using the concept of the zero of the polynomial. Right? Chaliye, ye to hua hamara zero of the polynomial ka concept. Ab hum chalte hain aage. And the next concept is remainder theorem. रिमाइंडर थ्योरम में से लॉन्ग डिवीजन मेथड आपके सिलेबस में से रिलेटेड है. फैक्टराइजेशन में से क्यूबिक वाली आपने नहीं करनी, जो भी बुक में है वही करोगे. क्यूबिक वाले अगर बुक में है तो कर लो, अदरवाइज क्यूबिक वाले भी लीट है, बुक वाले करेंगे हम. चलिए, लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट, दैट इज रिमाइंडर थ्योरम. रिमाइंडर थ्योरम, रिमाइंडर थ्योरम. रिमाइंडर थ्योरम एज द नेम सजेस्टेड, इट विल बी यूज टू फाइंड रिमाइंडर व्हेन वन पॉलिनोमियल इज गोइंग टू डिवाइड बाय द अनदर पॉलिनोमियल. जब हम एक पॉलिनोमियल को दूसरे पॉलिनोमियल से डिवाइड करते हैं तो रिमाइंडर फाइंड करने के लिए रिमाइंडर थ्योरम का यूज किया जाता है. अब ये रिमाइंडर थ्योरम है क्या वो देखते हैं. मान लो हमारे पास एक पॉलिनोमियल पी एक्स है एंड रिमाइंडर थ्योरम इज यूज टू फाइंड अ रिमाइंडर इन केस ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल्स. इन केस ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल्स, you know, when we learned in case of numbers, we use long division to see that what remainder will be there when 73 it is divided by 2. What remainder is there when 73 is divided by 2. Okay? Then in 8th standard, we have done long division method also. in which we learn how to find the remainder when x square plus 2x plus 1, it is divided by x plus 1. So we do the division and accordingly we get the answer. That means long division method is sufficient to find the remainder, not only in the case of the constants, but also in the case of the polynomials. But just to make the things easiest, one theorem is developed, that is remainder theorem, with the help of which we can find the remainder in case when one polynomial is divided by another polynomial without using long division. Long division ko use kiye bina, agar aap remainder find karna chahte ho, when one polynomial is divided by another polynomial, then what is the alternative? That is remainder theorem. Let us see what the remainder theorem is. Remainder theorem says that if one polynomial, say px, is divided by another polynomial x plus a, then remainder will be equal to p of minus a. Remainder will be equal to p of minus a. And what is the procedure to find it? This is the divisor. Iske saath hum divide kar rahe. Whatever divisor you are having, equate it to be equal to zero. And वहां से जो आपके पास x की वैल्यू आ गई उसको पॉलिनोमियल में पुट कर दो, यू विल गेट द रिमाइंडर. हैड इट बीन x माइनस a, अगर ये पॉलिनोमियल x माइनस a से डिवाइड होता, देन रिमाइंडर क्या आता? देन रिमाइंडर अकॉर्डिंग टू द प्रोसीजर इट विल बी इक्वल टू p ऑफ a. दैट मींस रिप्लेसिंग x माइनस a इक्वल टू जीरो, यू आर गेटिंग x इज इक्वल टू a, सो रिमाइंडर विल बी p ऑफ. Had this polynomial been divided by, this polynomial px is divided by a polynomial 3x plus 2, then what will be the remainder according to the remainder theorem? This will be equal to, equate this to be equal to 0 and get x from here. 3x is equal to minus 2, x is equal to minus 2 upon 3. So this will be p of minus 2 upon 3. So after 15 minutes, we'll meet again. One more period is there. So this is your break. You can have your foods, your lunch, and we are meeting after 15 minutes.